One of the longest running shows in the West End and Broadway is currently staged in Manila. Cats the Musical was first staged in the country in 2010 with Lea Salonga at the lead. Now another theater veteran is taking over. She starred in several West End productions such as Miss Saigon and Avenue Q. Joanna Ampil joins us live this morning. She has been Grizabella as well for the tour for quite a long time. Good morning, Joanna.
Good morning.
Thanks so much for joining us.
No, it's a pleasure.
Well, you know what? You wear many hats now because it's before we go on to talking about Cats, you've also done a lot of movies recently and TV. How is the transition? Because for a lot of theater actors, there's a bit of a difference.
Yeah, there is a difference because the audience becomes your camera. So that's slightly different. I had to adjust a little bit, you know, the scale down the acting. But it's both very, very rewarding. So yeah, I enjoy both mediums. So
of course. But I mean, we're here to talk about theater, which is your number one love. You've done so much stuff in the West End. But then when did you start with Cats? Because I know you've played Grizabella for quite a long time, since 2013,
yeah,
am I correct?
Well, the first time I did it was 2013, and I did the part for 6 months then.
Okay.
Then I went back to it in 2017 to 2018 for a year, sorry, a couple of years. And this time.
And these were all tours, right?
Yeah. The first one was UK tour. Second one was Middle East and China tour. And Europe, sorry. And this one is Asian.
Of course. And there have been rave reviews about, because Memory is obviously the standout song of the musical. And you've been getting rave reviews. I mean, it must be making you feel so good. I mean, you've
been so good to me. So
you've been
in
the West End for so long as well. So hearing all of these like wonderful reviews, and I'm sure it still makes
you feel. In Manila.
Yes, exactly.
Amazing. Really amazing.
It's different to come home.
Yes, absolutely. Because I don't know, you always want to be validated in your own country.
Right.
And I know that Filipinos are so, they're perfectionists and they love singing so much. So, you know, it's really, I'm very flattered.
But you were also home last year because one of your families in life, Atlantis Theatrical, you know,
yes,
staged
Waitress
and you were here for that as well.
Yes, with your brother.
Exactly. But let's not talk about my brother. But what's the difference between, because obviously now you're touring with an international cast. How does it feel to also be amongst like a full Filipino cast? I mean, seeing, of course, there's a difference, but there's so much heart for me when I watch a Filipino cast.
Yeah, I agree. Also, because this cast is very, very good. I mean, this must be the best one that I've been part of. So people need to see this particular cast. They're all superstars in my eyes. And I don't know, there's also so much heart in this one. It depends on the show also. I suppose as long as there's truth in it, then there's always, you know, you can always show the heart of the story.
Right.
And the people involved in the show. So, yeah.
In Broadway, Cats ended its run, but then it sort of had a revival in terms of touring. Why do you think that happened?
Oh, with Cats?
Yes.
I think it's because it's a classic and it's timeless and it appeals to a wide range of audience. That's why, you know, it's always going to be successful. It's a sure winner for producers.
Exactly.
To produce Cats. So, yeah.
And I'm sure you've also been feeling the warmth of the Filipino audience. And
yes.
I'm sure you see all ages as well, because Cats is pretty much for all age ranges as well, right?
Yeah, we had a lot of kids watching us last night, which was wonderful.
Before school.
Yes, before school. From Tuloy Foundation, actually.
Oh, beautiful.
Yeah, it was wonderful to perform for them. And we have a lot of adults crying and everything, you know, so it's a show full of heart. And also the people can relate to the story of the different characters from the show. So
you've played so many iconic roles. To ask you to choose what your favorite one is almost
hard.
Like choose one of your favorite children.
It's hard.
It's very hard.
Yeah.
But what kind of, I guess, because you always try to better yourself as a performer, right? What has Cats done for you to make you better yourself as a performer?
Oh, gosh. That's a very good question.
Miss Universe question.
Yeah, that's true. I don't know. I suppose the fact that I've done it for so long, you know, I always try to look for something fresh within the story of Grizabella, or I try to think about the people who can relate to it, you know, what their story is about, and I try to apply that to my character. So things like that. Maybe it stretched me as an actor.
Right, and Andrew Lloyd Webber, I mean, he's such a genius, but then we've also got, you know, a lot of local, because you've been part of local performances as well. How do you feel theater has evolved in the Philippines? Because you've, apart from bringing in things like Waitress and all of this, we have our homegrown sort of. We have Rock of Ages and all of that. Yes. I mean, did you ever see that that would happen?
No. Well, yes, because it's also the trend in the UK. So like Mamma Mia, you know, and the Queen musical. So it was going that way anyway. So I knew that it was going to happen, you know, all around the world. It's something that we just need to accept and embrace, I guess.
And would you, are you excited to look, you know, to maybe perhaps join one of those eventually? Because you're always coming back to perform, and we're so happy about that.
You know, I'm so open to doing so many things and exploring. So yeah, I would love to sing some Filipino songs also. So yeah.
Exactly. So I guess at this point, I'd like you to invite everybody to watch Cats, because there's still a few weeks left on the run.
We have a couple more weeks.
How long have you been going for so far?
Two weeks. So we are here for 4 weeks. So basically, we have two more weeks. This is until December 1 at the Solaire, at the theater at Solaire. It's eight shows a week. So we only
have eight shows a week,
and we only have Mondays off. So the show keeps getting better and better. So please come and see us.
Wow, and you still look so fresh, eight shows a week. How do you do it?
I don't know. I haven't slept, so.
I think high five there. But what, you know, in the end, before I let you go, what's next for Joanna Ampil? I mean, you've got Cats. Is this going to be your last run for Cats?
We have Singapore. So we're doing 3 weeks in Singapore, and then I come back here, and we are doing season two of Call Me Tita.
Exactly. Yeah. And that, people are looking forward to that too.
Yes,
I mean, this
so
is another avenue for you, and it's sort of comedy. So
yes, it's comedy.
Is it a challenge for you, or? Because singing, no problem.
I guess the hours of filming is a bit of a challenge, yes. But I absolutely love it.
So we're so happy to have you back home
thank
all
you.
The time. Joanna
thank
and Bill, congratulations on your Cats run, and I'm looking forward to watching it.
Yes, thank you very much.